Welcome on into the Rock and Refuel Recruiting Roundup. Jason Jewell and Jordan Hamm going over everything recruiting related in the state of Arizona. And Jason, the past couple weeks it's been a little quiet on the offer front, but we actually have a commitment and quite a few offers to get to. We'll start with James Stagg over at Desert Vista.
Yeah, the big tight end DN kind of surprised me. And he committed to Navy over offers from Louisville and Nevada and almost, 10 other Division I programs. I think this is an absolute steal for Navy. I mean, this is a kid, he's 6'4", 6'5", range, 250 pounds, can play tight end, D end, maybe could be an offensive tackle in the future. I mean, I just love this. This is a great get for Navy.
In terms of the offers, we have a couple of Big Ten programs coming in, giving offers to a couple Arizona playmakers, Solomon Enos and Michigan State. They extend an offer.
Yeah, so I mean, this is a guy, what else can we say about him? He's a fantastic player, arguably the number one player in the state of Arizona, 20 scholarship offers, right now. So far this season, he's just kind of doing what he does. He has 340 yards rushing. I'm showing his versatility as a 200 yards receiving, 200 yards in the return game, and he's also an excellent defensive back. So, it doesn't surprise me that the schools like Michigan State are coming in and offering. And the other, Big Ten offer is to Jacob Conover, the junior quarterback over at Chandler. He's getting scholarship offers despite being out, with an injury. His sophomore tape is very, very impressive, and that's probably why, and so is his early junior tape. So, just because he's missing these games isn't going to shut down his recruiting.
A couple of 2019 guys also getting Pac-12 offers. A guy that I know you really like. We'll start with him. Ty Robinson over at Higley plays defensive end as well as a little bit of tight end as well.
Yeah, so Higley head coach Eddie Zuby texted me Robinson's updated junior highlights, and I watched about four clips and realized this kid's an absolute freak. I mean, he already had offers from Iowa State and from Arizona State. Arizona is the latest. There's a little tie there. Vince Amy, the D-line coach at U of A, and Zuby coached together at Westwood quite a few years ago. So, but Robinson, 6'5", 250 pounds, playing defensive end. I mean, maybe could be a grow into a D-tackle or even an offensive tackle. Getting recruited is more like a jumbo athlete, but guys that are that big and can run, those are no-brainer type prospects to me. The second Pac-12 offer extended was to Jake Smith over Notre Dame Prep. He's a guy that's really just burst on the scene. We talked about him last week. Got Illinois and got a Vanderbilt offer. Those were his first two. His third one comes from Washington State.
And now, as we're focusing on the games in the state, last week Zadane Thomas had a huge game. He is our player of the week.
I mean, he did it on the biggest stage. It was a Thursday night game of the week against a very good team in Pinnacle. Centennial stepping up, playing a 6A team there in the 5A division. And Zadane, all he did was rush for 340 yards. Absolutely ridiculous. He's a one-man wrecking ball over there and scored two touchdowns. He's committed to Boise State, as we all know. And again, the Broncos are getting a very, very talented football player.
And in terms of breakout prospects, I know that you were at Liberty and Verado last week. Someone really caught your eye.
Yeah, so Liberty, I think, is loaded on defense, and I really like their junior, Ryan Puskas. He already has an offer from South Dakota State, but the guy that no one's really talking about right now that I think is going to be a Division I guy, actually, I know he's going to be a Division I guy, is defensive end Braxton Croto, only a junior, 6'5", 225 pounds right now, has a frame to be much, much bigger. Guys like him are very similar to Ty Robinson. He's going to be a guy that's going to be heavily recruited for Liberty.
And there are plenty of really good games this upcoming week, but two that really jumped out to us, Saguaro and Sunrise Mountain, and then Perry and Highland, and we're seeing some similarities with those two storylines.
Yeah, if you kind of look at it, you see that Saguaro, they're the number one ranked team, in 4A, and Perry is the number one ranked team in 6A, and we want to see, is Sunrise Mountain for real? They beat Liberty a couple weeks ago, and then they've ran through all the other 4A competition, and then Highland, they're the surprise team of the year, and they're undefeated with their new head coach, Brock Farrell, and if these guys want to show that they have the talent to compete, for a state championship, this is the week to do it.
A lot of really good stuff going on this week in high school football. If you're out at a game, make sure to use the Friday Night 360 AZ hashtag and share it on social media. We'll be sure to retweet you. Thanks so much for tuning into the Rock and Refuel Recruiting Roundup on Sports 360 AZ.